Hello students, myself Dr. Sachin Kapoor, and I wish you all a very warm welcome to this session of zoology lectures. The topic of our discussion today is animal tissues. As you know that tissue is a group of cells having similar origin and perform a particular function. There are four major types of tissues in animal's body, as you can see here: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, nervous tissue and muscular tissue. Study of tissues is histology. Out of these four tissue types, the most abundant tissue in the body is connective tissue. Nervous tissue and muscular tissue are two excitable tissues. Excitable means when you give a stimulus, the tissue responds. Nervous tissue is present in our nervous system. Nervous tissue not only includes neurons, it includes neuroglial cells also, which we'll discuss in detail. Muscular tissue, which refers to the muscles, is of three types. There are three types of muscles in the body, that is skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles and smooth muscles. Out of these four tissues, the first tissue to develop in an embryo is epithelial tissue. It is the first tissue to be formed in an embryo. It is the first tissue to develop in the course of evolution. If you compare animals of lower phyla with the higher phyla, we find that it is the epithelium which evolved first. Epithelial tissue develops from ectoderm, mesoderm as well as endoderm. Connective tissue is mesodermal in origin. Nervous tissue is ectodermal in origin. And muscular tissue is mesodermal. Out of these four tissue types, we'll first study in detail nervous tissue. So, nervous tissue, as I told you, includes not only neurons, it also includes neuroglial cells, which are also called glial cells. These are much more than neurons. Their number is 8 to 10 times more than neurons. Neuroglial cells we can further classify into central neuroglial cells and peripheral neuroglial cells. So I'm classifying neuroglial cells as central neuroglial cells, which are present in the central nervous system, and peripheral neuroglial cells, which are present in the peripheral nervous system. Neurons, which are the longest cells in the body. Please remember, neurons are the longest cells. These carry nerve impulses. Neuroglial cells do not carry nerve impulses. These are responsible for providing structural support, protection, and nutrition to neurons. These do not conduct impulses. Neurons conduct impulses and these do not have the ability to divide. Neuroglial cells have the ability to divide. You must have heard of brain cancers or the brain tumors. They are mainly because of the uncontrolled division of the neuroglial cells, so they are called gliomas. Neurons, as I told you, they're the longest cells in the body. They can be up to 1 meter long neurons in the body. A typical multipolar neuron consists of a cell body or the cyton. Projecting from the cyton are numerous dendrites and a long extension called axon. So a neuron has cell body, which is also called cyton or soma or perikaryon, dendrites and axon. If roughly we look at the structure of a typical multipolar neuron, as you can see here, these are the dendrites, and then there is a long extension which is called axon. So this long extension is axon. These are the axon endings, which further end at synaptic end bulbs. This is a lateral branch, which is collateral. So these extensions are dendrites. There can be thousands and thousands of dendrites in a typical multipolar neuron. There are neurons which can have a single dendrite and a single axon. They are called bipolar neurons. These are the Nissl's granules. This region from where the axon emerges out is the most sensitive part of neuron, and it is called axon hillock. So these extensions are what? These are dendrites. This is the main cell body of the neuron. This long extension is axon. This lateral branch is collateral. The plasma membrane of the axon is called axolemma, and the cytoplasm is exoplasm. These are the axon and bulbs. An axon is covered by neuroglial cells called Schwann cells. You can see these cylindrical structures. These form myelin sheath around axon. Myelin sheath acts as an insulator. So this cell is what? It is Schwann cell. Throughout the length of the axon, Schwann cells are present. So that was a brief introduction to the four tissue types, and we discussed briefly about the structure of neuron. In the next part of this lecture, we'll discuss the structure of neuron in detail, and we'll discuss about different types of neuroglial cells.